finna reach my goals. Hello everybody, my name is Spix, and in this video I'm going to show how to make this effect you just seen on screen in Vegas Pro. Now before the video starts, if you could drop a like and subscribe notifications on, that would be helpful. Thank you so much for 21k and let's start the tutorial. So once you are in Google Drive, you should see this. Now these are the plugin downloads. You wanna join my Discord if you wanna download these plugins. Then this is the sound effect. These are the presets you're gonna be using. This is the project file and plus clip. If you wanna see how I did it, check this project file out. Then here's the clip, and this is the Magic Bullet Looks file if you wanna do it in a different software or whatever. But yeah, anyways, let's get on to Vegas Pro. Okay, so here we are in Vegas Pro. Now I'm going to show you how to make the Twixtor slow motion manually and how to apply it automatically without changing any values. So I'm gonna show you how to apply it manually. So you would basically take a clip. I'm gonna quickly remove the black bars. So here is the clip. Now if you want to apply it manually without, like, so you wouldn't need to change anything, what you would do is go onto the kill, and when you see the red dots and when you see the damage numbers slightly appear, you want to go minus 26 frames back, then cut it, and then apply the preset. So you would be applying orb glow looks, add OK. And if you go 50 frames forward, everything should be synced up just like that. But if it's not synced up, of course you can change the values, mess with the values. But yeah, if the method I'm using works, then do that. But I'm gonna show you how to apply the Twixtor manually, basically. So what you wanna do is cut the clip when the guy is sort of in this position. His camera is not moving around and he's like about to get the kill. So somewhere around here, I'm gonna cut it. I'm gonna apply the looks preset. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off animate on Twixtor. Just like that. And change the main background motion sensitivity to 70. Something like that. Now you wanna keyframe the speed percentage again. So click on this animate. Scroll down till you see this. Now you wanna go 3 frames forward from the cut. So this is the cut, and I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3. Change it to 50. It's gonna make a keyframe. So for the first keyframe, make it a slow fade. The second one, make it a slow fade as well. So you wanna go back to the cut. You wanna go 50 frames forward. And then you wanna mark it. Just like that. So you wanna make it 300 on the marker you made. You wanna go 5 frames to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and make it 10, just like that. And then you wanna take this, make it a fast fade, so the one before the marker, and then on the marker, make it a slow fade. Now you wanna go 3 frames to the right, 1, 2, 3, and make it 50. So it should basically look like this. Now, you wanna go on the marker, and you wanna change this by 1. So as you can see, this says 70. You wanna change it to 71. And as you can see, it updates the frame, because no, Twixtor Pro in Vegas Pro is just broken, it doesn't work. So you have to update your frames using main background motion sensitivity. So change this by 1 every time you wanna see the changes. So as you can see, it's basically perfect for me, but if it's still not perfect for you, what you can actually do is go somewhere in the middle and make it 10. And if you can move, so basically go on the marker and you can update to see how it looks. As you can see, it's not unsynced, but let's say you need, like, let's say the kill happens too fast for you. Since this is 10, what you can do is drag this keyframe to the left, just like that. And when you update the frame, it will be even slower. So that's the thing you should know, but I don't need to do this. As you can see, my Twixtor just works just how it is. But yeah, once you got your Twixtor, everything should be fine. You know, it doesn't matter if you do the automatic way or the manual way, both ways work, but of course the manual will be better, because you know, you can control it. But anyways, once you got this, you should pre-render with Shift B to see if the Twixtor and everything looks fine. So this looks fine. Now I'm just gonna highlight the part of the Twixtor, just like that. I'm gonna highlight the part, and I'm gonna go to file, render as, and basically I'm gonna render that part out. So there's a thing you should keep in mind of, as you can see, width and height is 2560 by 1440, but this is supposed to match your project resolution. So as you can see your project resolution on the preview window, it says project, and as you can see, mine matches. It says 2560 by 1440, this says 2560 by 1440. Now make sure this matches, or else it's gonna go bad, the effect not gonna work. So make sure this matches with your project resolution. But anyways, here are my settings. You can copy them if you want, and then I'm gonna click OK, and then I'm gonna name this whatever, or you know, name this what you would remember, and then click render, and I'll see you when the render is done. Okay, so you're gonna take your rendered file, drag that in over here, and you wanna delete this, boom, replace it with the rendered file. Now you wanna make a new video check, so right click, insert video check. Now there's a thing you all have to do, doesn't matter who you are, you have to do this. So you wanna go to options, click on preferences, and go to video, and make sure GPU acceleration of video processing is turned off. If it's on, then you will have issues and then you'll be complaining and I won't be responding to you. So if you don't turn this off, then I'm not helping you. I'm not helping you if you don't turn this off. But if you have it off, then that's fine. Click apply, click OK, and then restart Vegas Pro, and then you should be fine, because this will fix all the mask issues. So many people have mask issues if they don't do that, so make sure to do that. And once you did that, restart Vegas Pro, then you can continue with the tutorial. What we're gonna do now is hold control and drag this up. This will duplicate the clips. Now you wanna cut it on the marker, which is on the kill, and delete the right part just like that. Now you wanna fade this in by something like 20 frames, and you wanna right click on the line and make it the third option. So this one, boom. And what you're gonna do is go to pan and crop on the top clip. You wanna enable masking, make sure to click this or nothing will happen. And what you're gonna do right now is click on this shape, so oval or silk mask creation tool, and you wanna make sort of this like oval shape. Don't make it too big, but don't make it too small. So make it something like a head shape, just like that. And what you're gonna do now is go by a few frames, and then keep readjusting it to the opponent's head. So as you can see, I'm adjusting it to the opponent's head. You don't need to like do it on every frame, because it's gonna position itself. As you can see, it's moving by itself, but yeah, just keep repositioning the mask to the opponent's face, and we're almost done. So yeah, sometimes you can't really see the opponent, so you just gotta predict where he is. But yeah, this should be good. Now when there's like a lot of light, when you see this, what I would do is I would just hide the mask, so move it up, this is gonna be too bright. But yeah, this is good, this is fine. Now on the top clip that we duplicated, that we did the panel crop, you want to go to effects and you want to apply orb glow, glow and mask, click add, and then click OK, and you should have this. Now we're not done yet. What we're gonna do with this to make it better is we're gonna like keyframe it, because as you can see, like the rays are like moving up and down, but I want it to just be still. So I'm gonna go to video effects on the top clip, and I'm gonna go to rays. So click on rays, and you wanna keyframe center, so animate this, and you wanna extend it just like that. Okay, so you wanna go to the first frame over here, and as you can see, there's this like sort of plus thingy. You can move it around, and the easiest way to move it is to move it on the preview screen. So as you can see, like I can see it on the preview screen, and I can move it around on the preview screen. So either move it just like this from here, or go to the preview screen and move it like that. But I'm gonna use the preview screen for this. So you wanna basically point it at the opponent's head. So where the orb glow will be, that's where you wanna point it. So do that, point it again. And as you can see, it's gonna like become straight. It's gonna look like nicer. So make sure it's like the light is shining to you. As you can see, shining to the ground. So you wanna position it that it's shining towards you. Just like that. Now there is some flicker here, as you can see this like sort of disappears a bit. And you can also decrease this, so you can like change the amplitude, go back, maybe make this lower. You'll be able to see it better. But you should pre-render to see how it looks, and yeah, it looks fine for me. So I'm going to render this clip because everything is fine for me. And like I said, if you got any mask issues, make sure to disable GPU acceleration, do all that. But anyways, highlight the part. So highlight all of this and then go to file, click on render as. Once again, make sure your width and height matches your project width and height. But anyways, click OK. Like I said, name this whatever. And then you can click render. And I'll be back once it's finished. Okay, so here's the render clip. Now check if it's okay. As you can see, everything is fine for me. So I'm gonna go to effects. And then I'm gonna apply Orb Glow Impact 50. So click add, click OK. And once you have done that, you should have something like this. Now, if you locate blur more curves, what you will see is this. So if you move this around, if you move the point, so basically this center, if you move this around, it will change position. So if your opponent is on the left side, you can move this plus to the left and it will go to the left. But if your opponent is on the right, so you can just point it to your opponent, point to the opponent's head, so the plus to the head, and it should go to the opponent just like that. You should zoom in and then you should zoom out. Now this is basically done. I also added some extra things you can add. So if you check color correction, as you can see, this will, like, change colors or whatever. And I also added temporal blur. If you check this as well, you should have this like sort of blurry effect, which kind of looks cool, you know. And then there's a kill. But yeah, I'm gonna uncheck these and I'm gonna check how it looks. And that looks fine. Now you can just, you know, add your sound effect and then the effect will be complete. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. Hope the tutorial helped. If you got any problems, join my Discord server. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Hope everything worked. Don't forget to follow my Twitter. I post a lot of updates on there. And I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.